It's the girl Jackie, and you'll notice my hair looks a little bit different. The curls aren't as like springy or whatever. It's because my hair is still wet. It's like obscenely hot today, so I really didn't feel like doing a whole lot of like blow drying or whatever, so I just kind of halfway did it, and I figure it's gonna be dry in 10 minutes anyway. The only reason I'm even bringing it up is because every time I do this with wet hair, I get a bunch of comments like, what happened to your hair? It looks different. So that's what happened to my hair. So anyways, today I'm gonna be talking about my top 5 mascaras. I've gotten a bunch of requests for this over the past couple months, so I figured I'd go ahead and do it. What you guys will notice is there is a mix. I have included some luxury mascaras and some drugstore mascaras. I generally tend to only get drugstore mascaras because I feel like mascara is that type of thing that you can get something just as good at the drugstore for a fraction of the price, but there are a few luxury mascaras that are worth the money, so I have included the ones that I think are absolutely worth the money. Otherwise, we're just going to be talking about drugstore mascaras, so let's get right into it. And by the way, because I know you guys are going to ask, I put all of my mascaras in this little bag so that I could kind of keep track of them, and I know you guys are going to ask me where I got it. So it's this little zebra print. It's like covered in plastic. It's waterproof. I really like this. I got this at Walgreens for like $12, and I just got it like a week ago, so I'm sure they have a bunch. They had polka dot ones. They had some other ones. Super duper cute, and for 12 bucks, you can't beat it. So let's get right into it. My number 5 mascara is by L'Oreal, and it's their Voluminous Million Lashes Mascara, and this is what it looks like. I really like this one because it gives volume, but it does so without making your lashes clump together. Let me show you guys what the brush looks like on this one. See how it's just really fine, and as you'll notice, not a whole lot of clumpage came out there. I really hate when I pull the wands out of the tube and a whole bunch of like goop comes out, because all of that is gonna end up on your lashes. And what I really love about this is that you can layer the crap out of it and it's not gonna clump up. I tend to layer my mascaras in the morning when I'm getting ready. I just do the regular 2 coats, but as the day goes on, you know, if I decide to go out after work or whatever, I might put another coat on, and you know, by the end of the day, I might end up with like 4 coats of mascara on and it won't clump, and you can reapply it once your lashes are dry and not have a problem. So I really like this one a lot. I think it's only about $9, and I get this at Ulta all the time. Buy one, get one 50% off. So I tend to stock up when it's on sale so that it's even cheaper that way. Number 4 is by Maybelline, and it is the Falsies Volume Express Mascara. I have been using this since it came out last year or something, I don't know, but I love this stuff so much. It's really good at building volume, and what really helps you build up really gorgeous lashes is this brush. So let me just show you guys. See how it kind of curves and then it's kind of flat? So once you rest it against your lashes and brush it up, it really coats the entire lash from root to tip so that it really builds not only volume, but a pretty decent amount of length as well. This one is not the waterproof one, and it really doesn't run on me either. I tend to have watery eyes, and so it's really important for me to have a mascara that's not gonna run down my face and make me look crazy. And this one is really cheap. I think this one is only, I'm gonna put all the prices down here because I can't remember off the top of my head. I usually get this on sale for like $6 or so. I tend to, like I said before, I wait for these things to go on sale and stock up so that they're even cheaper. But if you're looking for a really good drugstore mascara, definitely give this one a try. So number 3, this one is a luxury mascara, but I promise it is worth the money. This is Benefit Bad Gal Lash Mascara. This has been a staple for me for I don't even know how many years. I would say at least 10 years I've been using this, and this mascara is fantastic. When I started buying it, it was $19, but that was a really long time ago. I think it's up to $21 or something now. I find it worth the price because you get a lot of product, it lasts a really long time, and the formula builds up so much volume. It makes your lashes look really lush, really full, really dark, and it lengthens a really good amount. And I really love the brush because the brush is really, really big, and it just builds up really full, gorgeous lashes. It doesn't clump up at all. They were selling it in other colors. I don't know if they still are. I know that they had a blue one and a brown one, but definitely Bad Gal Lash is amazing. So number 2, my second favorite mascara, and this is probably at the top of a lot of people's list because it's so fabulous. This is also by L'Oreal, and it's their Voluminous Carbon Black Mascara. Now, they've had the Voluminous Mascara out for quite a number of years, but they started making the Carbon Black a couple years ago, and it is this really rich, intense black color that just just makes lashes look so much fuller, and the formula of this mascara is unbeatable. This, to me, is a luxury quality mascara that you can get at the drugstore. If you are looking for something that is going to give you maximum volume, this is definitely the stuff to get. It does lengthen, but it's mostly just volumizing, but you just have these lush, dark, really full lashes, and I love this stuff so much. Let me show you the brush. And they do make this in waterproof, but I don't buy the waterproof one. I usually stay with the regular one. So the brush is pretty simple. There's nothing special about it. Yet for some reason, it's clump-free, and it just really helps you build up really gorgeous lashes. And like I said, this is like a luxury mascara for a drugstore price. So if you want something really luxurious, but you don't have the money to spend on something at the department store, at Sephora, or whatever, definitely give this one a try. And my number one favorite mascara, and yes, this is a luxury mascara, but I just love it so much that there's no way that I could not make this number one. This one is also by Benefit, and this is their Real mascara. This came out last year, and this basically, they advertised this as something that was going to replace false lashes, which I will be honest, it does not. I, like, right now am wearing false lashes, but as far as everyday mascara, this will get you the closest to looking like you're wearing false lashes that you can get from pretty much any mascara. To me, this even beats all the tube mascaras. I don't really like tube mascaras that much because I find that the tubes tend to break off and they end up getting in my eye and just annoying me, or they end up down here and it doesn't look really well. It doesn't look good. Well, what the hell is wrong with me? Okay, but as far as mascaras go, to me personally, this is like the Jaguar of mascaras. Or, well, I'm sorry, not Jaguar, the Jaguar of mascaras, yes. I'm fancy. I don't know if you knew that or not, okay, but I'm fancy, so. Anyways, I really love this. So the formula of this is really, really volumizing, and it is lengthening and volumizing without clumping, but the best part about this one is the brush. So let me show you guys the brush. See how you've got really teeny tiny fine little bristles, and then at the end you've got this little spiky, like, it looks like someone with spiky hair or something like that. So you apply the mascara to your lashes, and then you use this little tip part to get into the inner lashes right here, like the inner corner. Because it's so small, it really gets in and it makes it look like you have a wider range of lashes. And so that's why it looks like your lashes might be fake. So like I said, to me, they don't look fake. I've seen other people use it and they look fake, but either way, this is my favorite mascara. This is $22 and I gladly pay, well, I don't gladly pay it. If I didn't have to pay $22, I would rather not. But this is my absolute favorite mascara. It has been since I tried it out last year. It trumps pretty much any other mascara that I use. And I will, you know, stray and go for other mascaras and stuff, but I pretty much always have a fresh tube of this on hand because I know that I'm gonna go back to it. It is like that boyfriend that, you know, you break up with all the time for whatever reason, but you keep going back because nothing compares. This is my, like, on and off boyfriend of mascaras, I guess, because I keep going back to it. So those are my top 5 favorite mascaras of all time. I hope you guys learned a lot from this video and hopefully you found something that you can use. Well, go ahead and let me know down below in the comments if you guys have any favorites that I didn't mention in this video that I might want to try out, because I'm very interested to hear what your top 5 mascaras are. So like I said, let me know down below. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you want to hear any more top 5s, like if you want to know my top 5 lip glosses or lip liners or anything like that, let me know and maybe I'll do like a top 5 series or something like that. So let me know that also down below in the comment. If you have not subscribed to me yet, please do so. The button is right up there and it is free, okay? And we have fun every week, and if you guys want to keep following my hijinks and shenanigans throughout the week, do follow me on Twitter and like my Facebook page. All those links are down below. So thank you guys so much for stopping by to hang out with me in this video, and I will talk to you next time. Bye.